Exciting science project? Yeah, let me show you. There are two common types of popcorn, stovetop and microwave. What I'm cooking right now is a stovetop juicy pop. The best thing to do for popcorn in a science experiment is the most simple thing, by counting the kernels. And that is exactly what I did. So you gradually shake the popcorn up and down over your stovetop. You never know when something can accidentally go wrong, so always follow the instructions carefully on the popcorn bag. Now while that pops, I'll explain to you more about my project. What I'm doing is counting the kernels in my stovetop popcorn and in my microwave popcorn. I'm comparing both of these popcorns to see which type of popcorn and where it is popped depending on the kernels. Now previously, when I first did my project, I got around 300 to 400 kernels in the stovetop. That's actually a lot. Although for the microwave, only had around 100 to 200. So they're very, rare and compatible. But it's still a good project. Another thing to do, when you're popping your popcorn, always make sure that you have your popcorn set on the correct time. You don't want to burn your popcorn, and you don't want it to be too early. Because of this, if you don't pop your popcorn not enough time, then not all the kernels in the bag will pop. And if you pop it too long, it's possible that it could get burned. Now, my hypothesis for this project was that the stovetop popcorn, of course, we have more kernels pop because of the more reaction to the heat and how much heat it was being pressed down on the kernels. Everyone loves microwave popcorn, but it's not always the best kind of popcorn to go with, health-wise, taste-wise, and fun-wise. See, the stovetop has more of a buttery taste. You can also do it on a campfire for those nights when you go camping. Although the microwave, it's more of a family type popcorn, and many people use it throughout today. Another thing about popcorn is a very good substance. It's good for you, and it's good to eat. So, if you like popcorn a lot, this is another reason why I suggest doing this project. When taking your popcorn out, always make sure that you handle it carefully. Okay, after you've popped your popcorn, both types, the best thing to do is count both of them and record your data. Once you've recorded your data three times, make sure that everything is complete with your hypothesis, your variables, and your constants. After that, you can just go ahead and enjoy it. Popcorn is good. Earlier I mentioned about performing the project itself and the data. Now my hypothesis was that the stove popcorn will pop more kernels because the stoves pop because the stove's amount of heat. Okay? So the first time I popped my Jiffy Pop stovetop popcorn, I popped 453 kernels. That's amazing. The first time for my Orville, only with a small 159, but it's still a good number. My second amount of my Orville was 135. It went up a little bit. And my second amount for my kernel for the Jiffy Pop was 456. That also went up. Now, my results is that I knew the stovetop popcorn would have over 100 more kernels than the microwave. Lucky guess. Conclusion. Next time I will use different brands and different types of popcorn. My variables are the time the popcorn was popped. My problem statement is, it is the type of brand of popcorn that makes more kernels pop. That's it. Now I can go watch my favorite show. While this cools off, like again I said, always follow the instructions. Never know when you can get burnt popcorn.
It don't matter if it's burnt, you can always get the experience.
Yeah, split it.
Wait, which one? That's on fire. Alright, while this cools down, we'll look at comparison and how many kernels were supposed to be popped and estimate how many kernels the stovetop has comparing to the microwave.
Can't eat it, dog.
Popcorn is good.